Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're going to have some Division 7 online ranked gameplay. And this is after the season has reset. Obviously, I was in Division 20, Season 4, and I'm looking to do the same in this Division, Season 5. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to showcase gameplay on my journey to Division 20. And I'll only show the more interesting gameplays or the best gameplays across the divisions. As you can see, I'm starting off in Division 7 this gameplay, and I'm fighting against an opponent, as you can see from his banner at the bottom, has been in Division 20 in two separate seasons, so I knew this was going to be a good fight. And I believe I've faced this opponent before, so I knew the sort of the skill level my opponent had going into this fight. As you can see, I've had four losses to this opponent, so this opponent's obviously of a good skill level or has the perfect game plan to beat me. And I actually wanted to use Rose Namajunas, but my opponent picked Rose, so I ended up using Wei Ling. I mean, Wei Ling is a very good fighter to use on this game. I feel she's very powerful, she's got very good combinations, she's versatile, she's decent on the ground, good in the clinch, and her stand-up's very good. So what I'm looking to do really is avoid the ground where possible. I'm just looking to have a build up of strikes. I mean, I know this opponent's got very good boxing, ground game's okay, so I knew going into this was going to be a competitive fight. And with the way the meta is shifted now, leg kicks are very prevalent of most people's game plans. They're used often, and it's something I've got to be aware of for. I mean, Rose is quite long and rangy, she poses a big threat, very clean boxing, so this is all stuff I had to consider. And where it's a 3-round fight instead of the usual 5-round fight that I'm used to from last season, the game plan you have to adopt is very, very different. I mean, and as you can see from my videos, I always say that if it's a 5-round fight, I take the first round off, I look to focus on picking up patterns. 3-round fights, you've got to do a better job. You can't take the first round off, you need to push, you need to pick up the patterns a lot quicker. Your stamina management is less of an issue because there's only 3 rounds to work with. And what I'm finding a lot is, throughout the games I have played, is that people will just try to hug you for 3 rounds and get the victory, which is very annoying. I mean, I can understand why people are doing it, they don't want to lose. And if we're being honest, ranked at the moment isn't the best to play, it's not the most fun. I'd rather play with friends just because of how people play. But my opponent here is not using anything cheesy, just fighting a normal fight. And when it's fights like this, even if I lose, I find it enjoyable because I was pushed, my skill was pushed. My opponent was just fighting a normal technical fight and not adopting any cheesy sort of meta. And as you can see at the moment, we're having a good back and forth. I hit my opponent with a beautiful uppercut as they go for a body shot, and we get the stun. So I know that now I've stunned my opponent's probably going to be a lot more aggressive. I look to see out this round probably in a dominant way, so I'm being wary. As you can see, both our staminas are fairly similar level, head health fairly similar, body health similar, so right now we're both fairly even. I'm attacking my opponent's lead leg quite a bit, trying to sneak in where I can. As you can see, I did so there. And here I'm just adopting the game plan. If I'm going to try to beat up Rose's legs, I've got 2 rounds to beat up both potentially, or at least the lead leg, and this can result in drops, so that's what I'm looking to do. And I'm looking to use Wei Ling's boxing mainly. So this round's coming to an end now. It was a fairly even first round, you got the stun, so just looking at the stats, the round could have gone either way. I personally would have said it should be my round, but the judging on this game isn't the best as it is in real life, so that round can go either way. It was a very close first round. And going into the second, as you can see, I have a slight stamina advantage, and I'm going to look to maintain that throughout this round. So going to the third round, that we have the stamina advantage again and we can push a bit more, because at the moment it's a fairly even fight. And as you can see, that weird glitch happened there where you go for a takedown and it just freezes, which I had it denied anyway, but it didn't do my opponent any favours. And this has been a very technical fight at the moment, and as you can see, my opponent's now starting to shoot for takedowns, wants to mix up the game plan, which is to be expected when using Rose. Rose is a very versatile fighter, and she's phenomenal on the ground, so the takedowns I've been expecting, my opponent didn't throw in the first round, maybe because he felt like he didn't need to, but in the second round is something that I can see is potentially on my opponent's mind. As you can see, I'm trying to use my distance management here. I do want to be in boxing range, but I've got to be careful because Rose's boxing is very, very crisp, and I don't want to get caught by any punches unnecessarily, which is why you see me go in and out of the pocket fairly consistently. My opponent's now starting to throw bigger strikes, if you can tell. My opponent's looking for that big head kick, and again, that mixed in with the takedowns could cause an issue, so I've got these stuff playing on my mind. And I'm just trying to remain calm, keep it a technical fight, which is easier to do now with this patch because the boxing meta's now gone. I mean, the new meta's kickboxing, but the block breaking's been nerfed significantly, so now you can actually afford to have these technical fights. And as you can see, we're over midway through this round, and it's been fairly decent round, back and forth, just like the first. I haven't managed to get any stuns like I did the first round, and I'm looking to minimise the damage I take. And I know that the way this round's going, one of us will need a big third round because there's not much in it between both of us. I think this round my opponent slightly edged it more, and me and my opponent's getting the better of these exchanges, landed a bit more punches, probably more significant strikes. As you see there, my opponent hits me with a head kick, which was beautiful. Then went for a head kick, which I ducked. The only reason I ducked it was because earlier in the fight, my opponent looked for the same head kick, so I just remember that's something my opponent likes to go towards. Unfortunately, I ducked it. And now that my opponent has that stun, you can see my opponent's pushing the pace a bit more, which is the right thing to do. Probably looking to see if it get a knockdown and secure the round. But that stun in my mind secured my opponent that round. And with the first round being 50-50, in my head right now, I was just thinking, okay, my opponent's up two rounds. Going into the third, I need a big performance. And that's what you've got to do, you've got to motivate yourself. If I went into the third round thinking I've won both these rounds, then I wouldn't push the pace, and I know that's what I need to do. I don't think I'm going to get the decision unless I get a 10-8 round, so I need to be very dominant this round. But I'm going into this round with the idea that I need to finish this fight. I know it's not going to be easy, but I've got the stamina advantage. I've beat up my opponent's lead leg, and I'm going to start unloading a bit more, looking for bigger strikes. So that's the game plan going into this round. I've also got in the back of my mind that my opponent might just take me to ground and look to hold me, because he may feel he has two rounds and I don't, which would be smart for my opponent, and I was expecting my opponent to do, which if I was in his position, I probably would look for the takedown. And as you can see, I'm pressuring my opponent here quite well, breaking the block, doing some damage to the head. My opponent's firing back, which in his position up two rounds is quite a risky thing to do, but my opponent obviously is very confident in his stand-up, as he should be. He's got a very good stand-up. We get the drop here, which I don't jump into Rose's guard because I don't think that's a smart thing to do. And we really put the pressure on this round. And because my opponent I haven't shown this to my opponent the two rounds prior, I haven't really gone for this pressure style of fighting. My opponent isn't sure on how to react. I mean, my opponent's throwing back, and that's leaving him more vulnerable. I mean, the right thing for my opponent here to do would be to push a takedown, which is what I'm trying to force out of my opponent. And as you can see, I'm being very pressure dominant here, and pressure fighting isn't over in this patch. It's just block breaking that's over. People tie pressure fighting to block breaking, which isn't necessarily the right thing. Pressure fighting is forcing your opponent in an exchange either they don't want, or forcing them to fight a fight that they don't want to fight. And that's exactly what I'm doing here. As you can see, I'm being a lot more tentative, a lot more aggressive. I'm beating up that leg where I can. As you can see, my opponent's leg health on his left leg isn't great. and I'm keeping my opponent towards the cage. I'm loading where I can, and my opponent's throwing big strikes to try to keep me away. And I know I just need one or two big shots to finish the fight. My opponent misses the body kick there, and as you can see, I put my foot on the gas and I pressure my opponent heavily. I'm now landing consistently more, hit my opponent with a beautiful uppercut. As you can see, I'm unloading here, hit my opponent with the uppercut again, we get the knockdown. And I really want to go for the finish, I don't want to leave it to the judges. So I'm keeping my opponent trapped against the cage. I'm waiting for my opponent to sway, so I keep throwing hooks. Break my opponent's guard again. We get on top here. And we get the finish. So that was the fight against a high level opponent. It was a very good close fight. Very tactical. But at the end we managed to push the pace and get the finish that we needed to. The scorecards are coming up now. I believe I was down 2 rounds going into the third, so I didn't need the finish. Thank you for watching the video. Please like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.